guys, welcome back to my channel. So today I wanted to show you guys exactly what I do when I diffuse. This is kind of like a two-part video. The last video I showed you guys exactly how I root clip, and once I air dry, I will root clip, and then after that, once my hair is about 50% dry, I will go in and diffuse, and this is the product. It's settled for about an hour now, so as you can see, when I fluff in the video, you can see that I have like a ton of volume, and my hair does stay like that for the most part because of my haircut, but also the diffusing helps a ton to keep it kind of airy. So if you keep watching, you'll see exactly how I diffuse. So I just air dried to about 50% dry, and my hair is in a bit of a cast. But my roots in the back are still a bit wet, and then my hair isn't completely dry yet. So I'm gonna show you guys how I diffuse, and I always air dry first just because I don't really have time to sit there and diffuse from wet to 100% dry. So I root clip instead to make sure that my roots don't get flat. And for today's video, I'm using my GDP hair dryer and then the Xtava extension. I also have the silicone one from Ion that you can also get at Sally's. The only thing that sucks about this one is it does kind of collapse while you're drying your hair, which isn't a huge deal. And this is awesome for traveling, especially if you don't want to carry your full blow dryer. But for the sake of the video, just to make sure that you can see how exactly I'm diffusing, I'm gonna use the Xtava diffuser today. So the first thing I always do is dry my roots. So what I do is I go into my root and lift and hold it there for about 10 to 15 seconds in each section. And I'll do the same all the way around until I feel like my roots are dry enough. And then I will go in and diffuse the length of my hair. Now you don't wanna be too crazy with your hair because then you'll create more frizz. Some frizz is obviously functional and doesn't really matter, but as far as when you're diffusing, because you're already gonna get a little bit of frizz from diffusing, so you don't wanna create too much frizz by going into your hair too rough, because you wanna be gentle because it is also in the cast. So what I will do is I will just go up and down, and I will hold it for about 15 seconds in each section, if not less, just depends how antsy I am. So I will usually diffuse on medium heat and high speed. So at this point, the back of my hair is still pretty damp. The front of my hair is almost 100% dry, but I just don't have the patience to keep diffusing. So I'm gonna finish air drying and just clip my hair in the back. Well, actually, let's take a look. So I'll keep, actually let me finish diffusing the back just so I can show you guys. So at this point is when I would prematurely scrunch out the crunch because my hair is still pretty damp in the back, but I just don't have the patience to keep diffusing it. I really don't, you guys. Like, diffusing is not my strong suit, and I encourage you to not diffuse for the rest of your life if you don't like it either. So now I'm just gonna show you guys how I fluff and scrunch out the crunch. So typically I will go in my roots and just loosen my hair. And at this point, I can tell that it's premature because my hair is not 100% dry. But, I mean, oh well. It's too late now. And then I will just scrunch out the rest. Okay, so my cast is really hard today, but I'll show you guys.